Problem 42, chapter 15 of Junkly 6 edition. So we have water. We have 1 kilogram of water at a certain temperature. I'll call this initial temperature Ti, 30 degrees. And I have also 1 kilogram of water at a higher temperature Ti for this other system, which is initially at 60 degrees. Okay, so I'm going to call this cold system my system 2, and this hot system my system 1. Okay, so this is the initial temperature for my system 1, and this is my initial temperature for the system 2. We put both in contact, they will reach equilibrium. They are completely insulator, like in a calorimeter, so there is no exchange with any environment. And we want to estimate the net change in entropy of this system. We know that entropy, change in entropy, is the heat, the exchange of energy, divided by the temperature, where this temperature is first given in Kelvin, so this is important to remember. And when we are thinking about phase change, this temperature is constant, so I just put this temperature there. The question now is, what temperature are we going to put for our two systems where the temperature is changing? Okay? What I know is the net change in entropy will depend on the change in entropy of system 1, my hot system, and the change in entropy for my system 2, which is my cold system. Alright? Alright, so the hot one will lose heat, the cold one will gain heat. Alright, so the amount of heat that the hot one loses is what the cold one is going to receive. Alright, so I know that this change in entropy will be the heat that the hot one loses divided by a certain temperature that I have to find out. What we'll put here, I'll put the temperature for the hot one, okay, plus the Q that the cold one is going to receive. So these two Qs are the same, and I have to decide what temperature I'm going to put in the denominator. So here, for the hot one, I cannot put 60 because the temperature, this is 60 degrees, is just the initial, and it's changing. For the low one, I cannot put 30 because that's the initial and the temperature is going to be changing. When the system reaches equilibrium, what is going to be the final temperature? Well, since both systems have the same masses, the final temperature will be something between the two. Okay, so the final temperature of this system will be 30 plus 60 divided by 2, so 45 degrees Celsius. Okay, this is what I know. So let's now think what we should put for this TH and what we should put for the TL. What we should put is the temperature in between the two extremes for each system. So if I think about the system, the hot system, it starts at temperature 60 Celsius and then it ends at temperature 45 degrees. So what is the temperature in between? This is what we are going to put as our TH. So the temperature in between, what is the midpoint? Is 60 plus 45 divided by 2. Okay, so the temperature is in between is 52.5 degrees. This is what I'm going to put for the TH. But careful, you have to write this in Kelvin. Okay? The same idea we are going to do for this TL. This is the system 2, the cold system. So initially the temperature is 30 Celsius, it ends up warmer, it ends up at 45 Celsius. So what is the temperature in between? So in between, the mid temperature is what I'm going to enter as the TL. Okay, so that will be 30 plus 45 divided by 2. Here we'll get 37.5 degrees. And again, careful, we have to enter this in the equation above in Kelvin. All right? So that's the idea. When we are solving a problem with phase transition, it's very easy to know which temperature we are going to put in the denominator, that constant temperature. When there are changes in temperature, then we have to find the midpoint between the two extreme temperatures of each system. And that's the end of this problem.